Hi, it's Citizen Chris again. Another audio test, actually. Hopefully this is way better than it was before. And I'm going to show you the Southland hangar just a little bit, to tease him. It's not the full tour. And discuss something that's just turned up on my Star Citizen, which I with the game-changing ship. Let's have a look. Anyway, first of all, let's walk through the door. And here we go. This hangar is the one most of you got, I believe. I think I use it much, but nothing wrong with it. Definitely a great hangar. But the I do have something in here. I have the Retaliator, the Tally as it's known. And this rather large ship, it's not my biggest, but it's rather one of the biggest. It's fun because it's a bomber. Do a full walk around with this sometime, but am I even in the right place? There it is. More than one way into all these things, but there we go. This is obviously a military plane. Get even more obvious when I show you the torpedo. Now, there are options in this, but I've got four torpedoes in the front bay. These long things here are size 9 torpedoes, I believe. And they're fun, and the bays open up when we fire them. We'll see that in another video. But it's obviously a specific role. I can actually modules. But this is a crew quarters here. And in the back, you see there's some Molotov in there. In the back, I can swap that module out. But essentially, this thing is a bomber. And it's not much good for anything else. And this. Hopefully in 3.0 they'll have sorted this out, but right now you can fire these and they move with the flexibility of a size 1 missile, which is just insane. But that's the fun of testing, you know? It's the fun of using an alpha. Anyway, my point is, there's a chin turret, which is quite nice. You've got a weird thing. We're going to turn upside down a bit. Not good for people with weak stomachs. Oh, there we go. Of course, with 3.0, we hope this is going to turn out to be a good turret. Moment. Horrendous. Although a friend of mine. From the Black Diamond Industries, they managed to hit something and kill it, and one of my turrets went up this one. There you go, the chair, you have to get quite up close to it. You end up doing the turret in there. Can you let me in or not? Well, it works better in the PU. Okay. And big ship. Big ship. And there's another turret. Up there. And some interesting stuff here. And some more red instinct stuff there. Some believe. I'm not getting a lot for that, am I? Not getting me in, is it? Okay, well, we'll go over that on another video. I want to show you the launcher now, so let me try and bring up the launcher. There's a lot going on. It says here, ship. So there's Tracker and Chaos and Kill, very nice, but shipyard careers and roles. And if I click on the damn thing, wherever it is it this thing? That's not that one. Must be over here. That's the one. I reckon if you click the link, this is where you end up. And it's talking about 3-0, and it talks about the new ship matrix, and they're showing combat roles, transport roles, exploration, industrial support, and competition. Now, we've been leaked. Well, I say leaked, we've been told by people like Ben. We all love Ben, wonderful guy. Nice to see him back with his eyes working. That the game changer is going to be big industrial ship. So you've got the reclaimer here, which is the one for picking up the wreckage after you've had your fights, and the massive Orion as well for the big mining of big asteroids. As opposed to the little prospector. But I think we could also be looking at some kind of transportation, but we've got, I think we've more or less got transport covered. Exploration, yes, I love the Aquila. It's my first ship I ever bought. Well, it was a Andromeda, then moved up to the Aquila. Carrick's wonderful. The reclaimer is just stunning at the moment. I wish I still had it, but since I have an Idris. Something had to go. But these support ones. Repair and refueling ships. So we've got the Cutlass Red in there. And this is, of course, for gathering fuel, where we may find space whales coming to chomp on our mighty starfarers. All looks good. And a little chart down here covering up roles. I just noticed there's two areas here missing. We've only got three. Freight, passenger, and data. That's the Herald, isn't it? Pathfinder, expedition, and touring. I'm making something out of nothing, but there's room to put another thing in with this game changer. Either way, I just thought you might like that momentary speculation by me. I'm going to pop over to the peak and show you something. There is a great video. Oh, there we go. Welcome to the Alpha. That's better look this time. I normally do, but in I go. I always keep it open because I've got a very long password, so. Know a lot of people might have shut it, but then I've got 32 gigs of RAM, which is plenty. So people are often surprised. Even in my something like 3 or 4 year old setup, I can play Star Citizen on full crack and something like all the warships at the same time. Having two monitors helps. Am I going to get like really? A reputation for telling you there was a UFO there, but there we go. Anyway. Like a UFO that's had a couple of asteroids hit it. Mind you, the bomb that's bottom right here underneath the Gemini looks like piece of Kentucky Fried Chicken to me. Probably why I'm overweight. gets me in the mood to play. I love playing with teams, but I love doing solo as well. Here we go. I'm going to try and show you the side opening up and just looking so beautiful. So we'll do a proper one. I really, really think that there's a good bend. Let's see. Another one over here. Occasionally get music from this one. I don't think so. I promise you I will do a Benny Hen. Anyway. All my dialogue are going to stop. To me, this audio sounds a lot better, but... But I doubt it in 3-0. It goes well, but we all now know where all the engine brakes are. So there's A, B, C, and D. Pod, section, struts, and every one of them have got 11. We now have the 0-0 for the big ships. So anyway, as I said, there's some really nice bits on this, but it looks a bit weird in the formation. This is a supremely beautiful ship, and I love it deeply. Not the best fighter in the world, never was meant to be, but got a few tricks. I wish I could extend the blades, but the blade's not currently. I've actually pierced ships for this. Here comes that operating system again. Strange, looks exactly like the Xi'an. And hopefully, it's not run forward this time. Take off without the time. Ooh. Let's go. And essentially there's two wings here. So when I press N, bring the other carrier. Hear that? So if I bring it back in again. This is it in its landing configuration, and from the back, isn't that beautiful? But look at all this red stuff. I promise you I'm pressing it down there. The interruptions in the sound, but you see all this red stuff? I was out at Grim Hex with this, and my teammates were saying how the red was lighting everything up. Such a beautiful ship. Now, if you've played Vandal Swarm, and if you haven't, don't know what you're doing. This ship basically will break into three. You can break the wings off, and the central section will still work. Is it harder to hit? I'm getting, definitely getting, mind you, this could be just the server. Anyway, I'm going to fight some guns. You can see there's some big guns. It's just the two on the front. I'll show them in a minute. And then the other one. Now there's a blade on the left here of our vision, and it extends, but I can't extend it right now. If anybody's got a way of doing it, as far as I know, it's gone buggy. 263, welcome to the Alpha. So these are the little guns, and these are the big guns. In the hands of a good player, this is a remarkable ship. Unfortunately, it's in my hands, so it's probably managed to land it badly upside down and destroy it and kill myself, so in the previous video. Citizen Chris signing off. I hope I've given you some food for thought, and have a good one.